I've been creating tutorials on YouTube since 2016, a lot of which include screen shares. And what I used to do is just record my screen and do a voiceover, which is great. But last year, I decided to try something new. And now my screen shares look like this. Here's me sharing my screen as I'm creating something in Canva, but as you can also see, I am on top of the screen recording. So it looks like I am walking you through what I'm creating as I'm creating it. This has made my tutorials so much easier to record and so much more fun. And it's one of the things I get a lot of comments about. How do you put yourself without the background on top of a screen recording? In this video, I'll show you how. There's really only two things you need. The first is a green screen. And if you're like me, you're like, nope, I don't want another thing to add to my workflow to make the video recording process even harder. I promise you, it is super easy to use, especially if you use the same green screen that I have, which is the Elgato green screen. The Elgato green screen is easy to store, easy to set up, and I promise you can have the thing ready in 15 seconds tops. Because this green screen is so easy to use, this is how it feels when I'm setting it up. And this is me setting it up in reality. See how quick it is? I always thought that green screens would be complicated, but the Elgato green screen has legs that flip out so it stands up on its own, it automatically rolls when it retracts so it never wrinkles, and you don't have to hang it or put it up against something for it to stand. It really is one of my favorite things to use, so if you want this same green screen, check out the link in the description below. Now the second thing you need is a program called Ecamm Live, and I've been using Ecamm Live for years for everything video related. Of course you can use something else, but what I really love about Ecamm is that it's super easy to create a scene where you're recording your screen and your camera at the same time in the same file. So here's my desktop and I have Ecamm open right here, and we're actually just going to create this scene from scratch. So I'm gonna hit the plus sign in the scene window and I'm just gonna call this green screen test. And as you can see, this is what it looks like when I haven't done anything yet. You can see the green screen actually up. Now we're gonna change the source to be a screen share because that's what I wanna focus on. I'll just focus on this browser window. I'm gonna zoom in so it actually fills up the entire screen. And then I'm gonna go to the overlay window and then hit the camera icon so I can add my camera. I'm gonna put me in the bottom right corner because that's where I wanna be. And then in the camera effects window, I'm going to click on the green screen effect to check that on, and it's going to add a background, but I don't want that, so I'm gonna hit transparent. And you can see that my green screen doesn't go all the way, right? So you can see my studio, wait, over here. So I just actually drag myself and adjust myself to be the right size and, you know, so that I'm filling up the whole thing so it looks like this. Hello, here's my screen. And all I have to do is press record and start going. I can't do that right now because I'm already recording, but if I wanted to change scenes back to a talking head without the green screen, all I'd have to do is switch my scene. My green screen is still here, but if I roll down the green screen, I'd be back in my studio. Are you okay?
Oh, could you see me?
Want to give Ecamm a try? Check out the link in the description below. So if you want to try this out, here are some things to keep in mind. So first of all, the monitor that I'm actually looking at is to the right of the camera as I'm facing it. So when I'm looking at the screen that I'm sharing, this is what my position looks like. If my monitor was on the other side, say it was over here and I was facing this way, you can see that it's kind of unnatural because I'm now facing the edge of the screen and not, it doesn't look like I'm actually looking at the thing that I'm showing you. If this were the case, then what I would do is I would position myself on this side of the screen so it looks like, you know, I'm facing the screen that I'm sharing. Next is that I use a boom arm, and right now you can see that the boom arm is coming from this edge of the screen. I actually moved it to that side once and it made it look like the arm was coming out of the middle of the screen. And it kind of just doesn't look natural. So I definitely had to move the boom arm so it was coming out of the edge of the screen rather than in the middle. The other thing you want to make sure to look out for is whether you end up covering something important on the screen recording. So there have been a few times where, you know, for example, I'm looking at a pricing page and I'm so caught up in explaining the pricing page and looking at it that I don't realize that some of the pricing is behind my head and the viewer can't actually see it. It's almost like doing choreography because I have to make sure that I scroll down far enough that my head isn't blocking any important text. What I really love about this is that it really does make it feel like I am giving you a personal tour the same way I would if I were touring you through a physical space, but showing you something digital. And probably my favorite part about this whole thing is that it really does make it easier to do these screen shares because I'm not having to record two separate things. It's all in real time. I could actually look at what it is that I'm explaining and just talk it out in real time. And as I mentioned before, I use Ecamm for all things video, not just screen shares, but tutorials, talking head, live streams, Zoom meetings, anything that has to do with a camera. So if you want to get started with Ecamm, you can check out this video here and I'll walk you through the basics. See you there.